गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, माई सेल्फ डी पवित्रा, आई एम फ्रॉम CSM बी सेक्शन. टुडे माई टॉपिक इज एक्सेसिंग इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइसेस. एक्सेसिंग इनपुट एंड आउटपुट डिवाइसेस इन डिजिटल लॉजिक एंड कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इंट्रोडक्शन टू इनपुट एंड आउटपुट डिवाइसेस. इनपुट एंड आउटपुट डिवाइसेस आर एसेंशियल फॉर कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन अ कंप्यूटर एंड द एक्सटर्नल एनवायरनमेंट. They allow users to interact with the system, providing data, input, and receiving output results. Understanding how these devices interface with the computer is crucial for effective digital logic design. Types of input devices. Input devices include keyboard, mice, mic, scanner, and microphones. Each device serves a unique purpose, converting user actions or signals into data that the computer can process. The selection of input devices can significantly impact user experience and productivity. Types of output devices. Common output devices include monitors, printers, speakers, and projectors. These devices convert processed data from the computer into a human readable form. The quality and type of output devices can enhance the usability of a computer system. The role of device drivers. Device drivers are specialized software that allows the operating system to communicate with the hardware devices. They provide a standardized interface for the operating system to send comments to input and output devices. Properly functioning device drives are crucial for the seamless operation of hardware components. Memory mapped input output uses the same address space for both memory and input output devices. They allows the CPU to interact with devices using standard memory instructions. It simplifies the architecture but requires careful management of address space. Port mapped input output uses separate address spaces for input output devices and memory. This method requires specific instructions for reading from or writing to input output ports. It can provide more address space for devices but complicates the CPU's design. Bus structure. A bus is a communication system that transfers data between components in a computer. Various types of buses such as USB and PCI facilitate connections between input output devices and the CPU. Understanding bus structure is vital for optimizing data transfer rates and system performance. Direct memory access (DBMA). DBMA allows certain hardware subsystems to access main system memory independently of the CPU. These processes enhance the performance of input-output operations by offloading work from the CPU. It is particularly beneficial for high-speed data transfer tasks such as disk writing. Interrupt-driven input-output. Interrupts allows device to signal the CPU that they require attention, enabling more efficient operation. This method prevents the CPU from constantly pulling devices, reducing wasted processing time. Understanding interrupts is key to effective system design and resource management. Polling versus interrupts. Polling is a technique where the CPU repeatedly checks the status of an input-output devices. While simple to implement, polling can lead to inefficient CPU usage and increased latency. Interrupts are generally favored for their ability to handle events asynchronously and more efficiently. Input and output is assembly language. Assembly language provides low-level instructions to interface with input-output devices. Instructions like in and out facilitate direct communication between the CPU and peripherals. Learning assembly language is beneficial for understanding the underlying operations of input-output processes. Buffering techniques. Buffering temporarily holds data while it is being transferred between devices. This technique helps manage differences in data transfer rates between the CPU and input-output devices. Proper buffering can enhance system performance and reduce data loss during transmission. Error handling in input-output operations. Input-output operations can encounter various errors such as data loss or device malfunctions. Implementing robust error handling mechanisms is essential to maintaining system stability. Techniques include returns, timeouts, and error logging to ensure reliable input-output operations. Conclusion: accessing input and output devices is a fundamental aspect of digital logic and computer organization. A clear understanding of the principles and techniques involved ensures effective system design. Continued study in this area is vital as technology and user needs evolve. Thank you.